If this movie does good, James Gunn's going to use them. Go see it.
Emma and I went and saw Hulk while I was in...
Welcome, everyone, to another episode of Movie Talk Monday. I am your host, Harley, as always, joined by the wonderful Felix.
Sup, I'm wonderful again.
And also the nerd tender.
How's it going?
What's up, Brandon? Going all right, man. What's up with you?
It's good to be back. Yeah, I've been gone for like a couple weeks. I had freaking COVID, and then leading into that, or right after that, I had to fly to Idaho and take my daughter to college. So it's good to be back.
That's what's up. How did that go, man?
So it was fun. Yeah, we had a great time. It's always hard to say goodbye, but I'm proud of her. Yeah. She's going to do awesome.
Yeah. That's what's up. It's all that matters.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we are going to start our show off with a moment of silence for those that we have lost this week.
It's always hard when we do those. I just picture them in the roles that I've seen them in movies. That last one there, Andrea Evans, she slipped through the cracks a couple weeks ago when she did pass away. She played Tina Lord or Tina Roberts on One Life to Live back in the day. She was Vicky Buchanan's sister, if I remember right. And she kind of like, you know, that you like women with those spunky roles, Harley. Her and... what's her name? Reva Shane from Guiding Light. They had that spunkiness to them. And every time I think of people like that, I think of What You Say. So that was a sad week.
The wrestler guy, he was only 36 years old. So that
is sad. That's younger than you, Norley.
Yeah. And like barely. WWE did a whole, like, they stopped and shut down everything to do like memorial for him.
Yeah, super sad. I saw that.
Yeah. Okay, let's move on to our shirts. Guys, we have shirts. These are the six we have all the time. And this is our shirt of the month. You guys only have very limited time left to get this shirt. Scan that QR code up here in the corner. If you'd like to get one of these shirts, you only have till the end of the month, and then it goes into the vault.
Yeah, like I'm thinking now. Like 3 to 4 days right after this episode drops, it's going to be gone.
Yeah.
Yes. Also, don't forget our Mod Squad community. Guys, scan that QR code right here at the bottom and go check it out. We always have giveaways going on till the end of the month. Check us out.
We giveaways all month long.
And our sponsors this month, we have Scott Straka Art. All this art behind me is his. Scan that QR code also. You'll get right to his site. And he has new art coming out for this season because it is spooky season. Woo! We also have Skolectomy by Jilt 7 Studios. Guys, go check out Lisa. She is a wonderful person, and let them know the Mod Squad sent you.
Yep.
Okay.
I'm so stoked about spooky season.
I know. And Scott has a lot of new art coming out that he's putting out this month up until October for spooky season. And they are so awesome.
Cool.
Okay. Let's go on to our first trailer. It is The Good Burger 2.
Oh, hey, Jackson!
Hey, man. You almost caught
Burger so me today. For
new adventures
movie.
Of Matt and Dex starts now!
Welcome to Good Burger, home of the Good Burger Camp. He's a kid,
he's a kid, she's a kid. We're all just hey. Water?
I think so.
I just love
oh, yeah, that's water. Tell.
None for me, thanks.
Yeah, that takes me. Really does.
Who loves orange soda?
It's so funny. It's awesome seeing those guys together again. It's been a long time.
It takes me back so much to like the 90s when they were on All That.
All and That.
The Good Burger.
Yeah, All That.
Like, I remember All That.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Me too. That was good shit.
That's when Nickelodeon was actually decent.
Yeah.
Hey now, Cujo watches Nickelodeon nonstop. Easy. She likes Paw Patrol and the little pig thing. Yeah.
Okay. Well, the morning the Disney Nickelodeon channel? Is good.
What?
I said the morning Nickelodeon's says, what? Good. No.
That was too fucking long, man.
I was going to say, that's really long.
That's why you need to let me click it, because I know when to take it off. Coming soon. On August 30th, we have Slaughterhouse.
Yes.
On September 1st, we have The Equalizer 3. All Fun and Games. The Good Mother. Morales. Don't Look Away. On September 4th, we have The Evil of Dracula. And Crypt of Evil. What are you guys looking forward to?
You know what I'm looking forward to? You want to know what I'm looking forward to? Boom. Right there. Blue Beetle. So go see it.
I saw it.
What'd you think?
Have you seen it? I liked it. I liked it better than a lot of the DC movies. I think they did a pretty good job. I really liked the fighting, the choreography and stuff. That was really cool. The action scenes were really cool. I think they went a little over the top with the whole family. It was a little cheesy for me. Grandma was a little cheesy, like, you know, with everybody loading up with the weaponry and everything. But I mean, it was a good family movie. So there's going to be some cheese to it. And I don't think they overdid the cheese too much. So it was pretty good. But yeah, I really liked, what's his name? Solo, right? That's how you pronounce his name?
Yeah, Solo.
He's awesome in that. He was really good.
I hear he's got the really good charisma in it. Yeah, you've seen Cobra Kai, right?
Yeah, of course. And I was going to say, his acting has gotten a lot better since Cobra Kai, too. Like, it wasn't terrible in Cobra Kai, but you can tell he's grown a lot as an actor. He's definitely done a good job switching over to movies, I think. So I do hope they use him more, use him in the future of the DCU.
I hope he's going to be in the Brewster Gold series, because Brewster Gold and him, I learned this from Kevin, are really good friends in the DC universe. So hopefully they use him when they do that TV show.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, so we are moving on to our deleted scene. This week the
hold on, son! I'm coming! Now!
Steve, we just have to upload the kill code and we'll shut down the...
Oh, what are you doing here?
I've been up here ordering dinner for the last 10 minutes.
Going on? I gotta stop the machine. There's a spaghetti twister tearing up the town.
Oh, it can't be that bad.
Speaking of Scooter,
I can still stop the order with the kill code.
I know you checked.
That's the reason why you got this, huh?
My kid loved this when he was little.
This movie was cute. It still is.
I haven't seen this in years.
You know what? I was gonna say that too. I have not seen this movie.
Yeah, Chance loved it when he was little. He used to watch it a lot.
Right back.
Sorry, Flint. It's nacho day.
Oh shit! He killed them with Doritos.
Now, I'm coming.
A pleasure to beat
Matrix action there. Yeah. Harley, since Brandon and I haven't seen it, you want to let us know what that was all about?
Well, when he did this whole machine to feed the town, the machine kind of went caca and like food
went,
was
what?
Getting it.
Went caca. I've seen the movie, but it's been like 10 years. My kid loved it when he was really little. So
I've never seen it, to be honest with you.
My 11-year-old still watches it. So like the town started filling up with all this food that more than what they could keep track of.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like a weather changer, and it creates food in the sky, and it just randomly rains down all sorts of different types of food and stuff. They start having like crazy weather patterns with
food
falling food. Yeah, it's pretty
good. A side of scrambled eggs coming in.
It's
like
pretty good.
Spaghetti and pizza and brownies, yeah. And it's just everything.
Yeah,
it's getting me hungry actually.
Okay, moving on. From Joe Blow, not another church movie. Jamie Foxx to play God opposite Mickey Rourke's devil in new comedy.
I'm thinking that's going to be somewhat like a Airplane type Naked Gun, and I'm looking forward to that. There hasn't been a good movie like that in a while.
Yeah, we were talking about that a while ago. It's been a while since we've seen a good spoof movie. And we were talking about it when we watched the Scary Movie deleted scene. And I love Not Another Teen Movie. That's a great one. So I'm curious to see what they're going to do with this one. I love Jamie Foxx and Mickey Rourke. So.
Yeah, here's see if it's like that or if it's a whole nother way of doing it.
Right.
But guys, here's a synopsis to said movie.
An ambitious young man given a holy mission from God himself to tell his family's stories and inspire his community. His only concern, his family and community. What he doesn't know is that the devil has plans of his own.
Doesn't sound too spoofish, but I hope it is still.
Yeah.
From Joe Blow, Kevin Hart lands himself in a wheelchair after racing former NFL star Stephen Ridley in a 40-yard dash.
Yeah, about 5 years ago, I used to tell my nephew, I can beat you. Let's go. Let's race. Come on. I can beat you. I still think I can run. Let's do it. And you know what? This will probably happen to me. Here's what Kevin Hart had to say.
Get out there, we go run the 40-yard dash, Hart said. 40-yard dash. Guys, I blew all my shit. Tore my lower abdomen, my abductors. I don't even know what that is, but I tore them.
I don't even know what that is.
I can't walk, sit my ass down. This is 44. That's crazy. That's a lot of shit to tear, and those are some strong muscles. And Kevin Hart is in shape.
Little guy.
He's a pretty tough dude, so for him to tear all of that shit doing a 40.
Does that mean what he didn't do like stretches or?
I don't know. That's crazy. I mean, that's just racing somebody, you know, and he ran too hard and tore all of his shit. That's wild. That's got to be painful. That's got to be so painful.
In the article, it said he said that he felt like a dumbass for running and doing it, even though he knows he's old as hell and shouldn't be doing it.
I mean, yeah, he shouldn't be doing certain things. He's only 44. That's not old as hell. And
check out Tom Cruise. He's like, what, 60?
Exactly. Yeah.
57.
It all just depends on, you know, how well you take care of yourself. And he's in good shape, so I'm surprised he had that bad of an injury from sprinting, you know, from a dash. That's crazy.
Makes you wonder what happened to where he did he fall to that happening?
Yeah, yeah.
Or
I think he just tried to overexert himself.
Yeah.
He just overexerted himself, went too hard.
Yeah. Well, Kevin Hart, you're in our thoughts.
Yeah.
Recover and don't be doing no 40-yard dashes rest again. Up. Learn your lesson.
What she said.
Because we know you're watching right now.
Yeah. From The Hollywood Reporter, Suits creator on surprise resurgence, potential spinoff, and writer pay.
This is all you.
Okay, so Suits came out in 2011 originally. And as of here, since June, when they put it on Peacock and Netflix, it has gotten a spike in the viewership that it originally had. So now they're talking about a spinoff. And the writer in the article said, don't worry about what I'm getting paid. Worry about watching the show. And
that's what's up.
Like, if you guys haven't seen this show, it's a really good series. I suggest check it out. It's about this.
Didn't you just start it?
Well, I'm on season 7 or 8 now of it.
Oh shit, there's a lot of seasons.
Yeah, but I stopped to go back and watch another show. It's a really good show. So
I've heard it's really good. I haven't taken the time to watch it, but I like when there's that many seasons of a show because, you know, it's usually it's going to be pretty good and it's worth
taking it. I noticed since Harley's been talking about it, I noticed it on Netflix, like on number 6.
Mm-hmm.
And it's an older show for it to be on number 5 or 6. That means it's good. People are watching it. Yeah, I'm going to check it out.
It originally came out in 2011. And since June, they said the viewership of it has gone up a lot since they put it on Peacock and Netflix. From comicbook.com, Godzilla versus Kong sequel delayed 1 month. That makes me sad.
We're going to start seeing a lot of delays next year because everything's being delayed right now. Nothing's in production. Nothing's being written. Nothing's being promoted. So, you know, until this strike ends, especially, But I mean, what's going on now is going to have a huge impact on the stuff that's supposed to come out next year. So yes. I think we're just going to start seeing more and more delays, unfortunately.
I think they switched it with another movie, though, and they feel better about its placement now, where it's at.
Yeah.
And it's more towards the summer, and, you know, they want that summer money. So,
yeah, I'm looking forward to it because I really, really enjoyed Godzilla versus Kong. And especially Skull Island. I loved Kong Skull Island. That one was really fun.
Yeah.
I want more like that.
I went into it thinking, I have to see it just because of the whole universe thing. Yeah. And I ended up, you know, pleasantly surprised.
Yeah.
But what's the synopsis for Godzilla and Kong?
Synopsis. This latest entry in the MonsterVerse franchise follows up the explosive showdown of Godzilla versus Kong with an all-new cinematic adventure, pitting the almighty Kong and the fearsome Godzilla against a colossal undiscovered threat hidden within our world, challenging their very existence and our own. The epic new film will delve further into the histories of these titans, their origins, and the mysteries of Skull Island and beyond, while uncovering the mythic battle that helped forge these extraordinary beings and tied them to humankind forever.
Sounds pretty good.
My 12-year-old son is like super excited for Godzilla altogether. Like, he has been huge Godzilla fan. He likes the originals, the black and whites with the subtitles. Oh, yeah. Like, big Godzilla fan. His whole bedroom is Godzilla and Jurassic Park.
He likes the dude in the rubber suit, huh? That's awesome.
Like, one Christmas, all he wanted was... No, for 2 Christmases in a row. Nothing but Godzilla toys he wanted. Do you know how hard it is to find Godzilla toys the second year he wanted them when he already had them all the first year?
Right. That's awesome. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I can't wait.
Okay, let's go on to our second trailer. The hell?
Do you know the story of the Princess Issa?
Oh.
It was said this child would stop the madness of war. That she was to usher in a new age of peace and compassion. I was given memories of a world I will never see. Loyalty to a king I cannot serve. And love.
This is hey, Brandon. Child,
I could not.
What do you think they want?
Did you
see? Everything.
I found her.
A scar giver.
I am a child of war. I was taught that love is weakness.
There is a difference between just...
There is a price to pay for your defiance.
Shh, one moment. I do love this part.
Hold on.
I don't want no trouble.
We're not here to bring any.
Are you ready?
You and I both know fear.
I don't know, man.
Let's show them that we're not afraid. Let's show them we are more than the shackles that bind us.
A king is a man, and a man can fail. But a myth is indestructible.
Has come for all that you love. Protect each other and show them no mercy.
Was lightsabers?
Who among you is willing to die for what you believe?
Honestly, I was more excited for it. I was more excited for it before this trailer. To be honest with you.
I might have to watch it though.
Yeah, I like Zack Snyder. I like Zack Snyder. I like most of his movies.
I mean, Zack Snyder, you know, say what you will about him. The guy's a really good storyteller. And, you know, I've enjoyed the majority of his movies.
Same
and man. I'm kind of surprised that like this looks like a movie that should be out in theater. So I would be kind of surprised if they didn't do like a special limited release or something in theaters.
With damn date.
It looks pretty like an epic type movie, and I kind of like that it has a cool like sci-fi fantasy mashup feel to it, which is pretty cool. And I love a couple of the casts, like Jimon Hounsou, I think that's how you say his name, and Ed Skrein.
Yeah, he's in a lot of good movies. He always plays a bad guy.
Isn't the guy from Sons of Anarchy in there too, the blonde guy?
I thought
because that's what Charlie it looked Hunnam, like.
Charlie Hunnam. I thought I spotted him for a second there too, but it was kind of glitchy for me when it was playing. I couldn't tell if that was him or not. I'm not sure if he's supposed to be in that or not, but yeah.
Because it looked he's like awesome him. That's too. Why I was like, ooh, he's in this movie. I have to watch it.
Yeah, Charlie Hunnam is in that. Yeah, that was him that we saw.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
That is awesome. Okay, let's see. We are moving on to... Okay, this was number one 10 years ago.
Still never seen it.
This was number one 20 years ago.
Holy shit.
That's what's up.
It's been 20 years.
And this
makes you feel old, doesn't it?
This was number one 30 years ago. This has been number one for a while now.
For a while. Yeah, I remember, like, because I was been gone the last couple weeks. And that was...
Well,
That was the number one I was on.
Yeah, that one will be number one till like September 27th.
Oh, shit.
Freddy versus Jason, I'm assuming to us, makes you feel like that much older.
Dude. And you know what? That movie still holds up for me. I love that movie. It's so good. It's not a great movie, but it's so much fun. And just seeing those two finally on screen, I remember, because that was, 20 years ago? So I was 18. And, I'd been a Jason fan for my entire life. So that was a dream come true. So
it's crazy that that's 20 years ago. Harley. I was only like 17.
Yeah.
And we were just a little older than that.
Okay, so what are we watching this week?
This week, we just started Ahsoka. We saw the first two episodes of Ahsoka. First episode kind of reintroduces all of the characters. Second episode starts framing up like what the mission, what's going to happen next. Am I enjoying it? Yeah, it's right there. The next couple episodes will make or break it for me, but I'm enjoying it so far.
What are you watching this week, Brandon?
I haven't watched Ahsoka yet. I just haven't had the time, honestly. But while I was gone, I was at my sister's, and we started watching Ballers. That's the one with Dwayne The Rock Johnson, the HBO series. It's on Netflix now. And that's a really fun one. I watched the first few episodes of that. That's one that I got into that's pretty fun. Movies, like the newest one that I watched was Blue Beetle last weekend. So,
well, this week I went back and started rewatching the Santa Clarita Diet.
Oh yeah.
Oh, that's a good show.
Yeah, that was one I was super bummed that
it got canceled.
I was so mad.
Cannot believe that they canceled that show.
And then the daughter in that show actually plays one of the younger versions of one of the main characters in Yellow Jackets. So there's something you want to, you know, if you kind of like the cast there, I would go that way.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Remember, we have t-shirts. Those are the six we have all the time. And that's our shirt of the month. You only have like 3 days from when this show comes out to order it.
Forget it. It'll be gone forever.
Up here in the corner.
Goes into the vault.
Also, don't forget our Mod Squad community. Go ahead, scan that QR code down there at the bottom by Brandon, and it will take you right to our community. And as always, check out the Daily Dank and Back to the Retro. And also, the last podcast you'd want. That is it for this episode of Mod Squad Movie Talk Monday. For Felix, Brandon, myself, and the entire Mod Squad, see you next time, Puddin'.
See ya.